This is the SAP Developer News for October 31st, 2024.
If you follow the announcements from SAP TechEd 2024, you know that there is a brand new SAP Cloud SDK for AI, for JavaScript, Java, and ABAP. So I thought, why not create a brand new CodeJam to teach you how to utilize AI capabilities within your CAP application using the SAP Cloud SDK for AI JavaScript version. So that CodeJam is out right now. So go ahead, visit the community.sap.com to see if there is a CodeJam happening right nearby you. Or if you want to host one yourself, there is a ton of description on how to do that. And hopefully I'll see you next year in a CodeJam talking about AI and CAP. I can't wait.
It's a long way from Philly to Heidelberg, but the show must go on.
We're late, aren't we?
Yeah, we're late.
We all know there's nothing like the real thing. Luckily, we've got our best people on the job.
Oh, sorry, Josh.
Gosh, if you pulled your own weight, we wouldn't have to carry you through this place.
Come on.
I've been coming up hot for a minute. We at SAP are enhancing our cloud-native data management product with advanced machine learning and artificial intelligence technologies, providing robust tools for developers and data scientists. First, the SAP HANA Cloud Knowledge Graph Engine, announced at SAP TechEd Virtual, is essential for developers and data scientists among you working with large language models or LLMs and generative AI, as it facilitates the extraction of complex insights from vast datasets. Check Shabana's post to find out more. Next, with the release of SAP HANA Cloud's Vector Engine, our development team built an insightful Movie Insight demo app to showcase the vector-based querying and storage capabilities. This demo illustrates the Vector Engine's role in enhancing LLM responses with contextual data. The entire demo is now available to you, providing a hands-on experience for developers and tech enthusiasts like you to explore the Vector Engine's capabilities and applications. To see such a practical implementation, check one of the partner applications known as SBF or Smart Budgeting and Forecasting. Summarizing long documents and querying using retrieval augmented generation with SAP HANA Cloud Vector Engine, this application enables a quicker understanding of the attachments to budget request forms. In addition, SAP DataSphere, in collaboration with NVIDIA, integrates Federated Machine Learning, or FedML. This setup allows data scientists to conduct extensive ML experiments on SAP business data while ensuring data security and stellar performance. Finally, the integration of data robots AI models into SAP environments empowers developers and data scientists to embed AI-driven insights directly into their workflow. The partnership enhances the technical capabilities of SAP data management tools, making it easier to deploy and manage AI models within existing systems.
Did you know that SAP, in particular the Open Source Program Office within SAP, has a podcast show? It's been running now 4 years, and to celebrate their fourth anniversary, they've published a monumentally epic episode. What is the episode about? Well, in my opinion, it's about one of the few major milestones in SAP software history, and that is the port of SAP R3 to Linux. Now, you might think, oh, what's the big deal? But back then, and this was in the early 1990s, back then it was a massive deal. I was super lucky to be around at the time to get to know the two main actors in this affair, in this amazing event, Christoph Roland and Harold Cook. And these two, Christoph and Harold, are guests on this particular anniversary episode of the podcast show to talk about how it came to be, what happened. It's an amazing story. I can't recommend this episode strongly enough. Anyway, get the podcast show into your favorite podcast player, have a listen, and while you're at it, also have a look at this blog post from Ulrika, which talks a little bit more about the show and also specifically about the milestone that Harold and Christoph will relate to you. So, see you online, and by the way, happy birthday, the open source way.